Hey, what is going on, everybody? It is 808 Testicle here, and today we're going to be making a crazy sample drill type beat in a style of K-Vlog. You know, I spent a lot of time on this video, and I'm pretty excited to show you guys. You know, you guys are going to get to watch me drag my slimy Vaseline balls against the keyboard while I make the craziest New York drill beat in history. So as you can see, we're going to start off with Nutsack Compression 3 here by Scrotum Audio. You guys can get this plugin for a very cheap price if you use my promo code Testicle03. You'll be able to get this for 30% off.
What the fuck am I on about, bro?
Wagwan boys!
It's Sim, bro. And today's video, man, I'm doing a how to make sample drill in 2023 tutorial, man. And I swear to God, bro, this will be the last tutorial you will ever need, yeah, on sample drill, man. Now, I've seen a lot of sample drill tutorials all over YouTube and stuff, yeah. But the problem is, yeah, that a lot of the people that are making it, you know, it's either garbage, it's dusty, right? Or they just don't know what they're doing, bro.
I feel like the sample's a little sharp.
But me, on the other hand, bro, you know, I actually know what I'm talking about a little bit. You know, I'm not to brag, you know what I'm trying to say? But, you know, I've got various placements, you know, in the New York, you know, sample drill type, you know, field. Like, I'll give you an example, man. It's Shah EK. I've produced tracks for D-Thanrex, didn't drop, unfortunately, because he went to jail. Ron Suno, and, you know, a bunch more people, man. So you guys can trust me when it comes to this, man. In today's tutorial, you know, I'm going to actually make it with you guys, you know. And I'm going to take you, you know, through the process step by step. So you guys, man, don't worry, man. I got you, blood, man. After you watch this video, you're going to be making bangers for days, bro. Okay, so let's get started anyways. Step one, get the blood clot limiter off the mat. Step two, now you're gonna find any tune you want, bro, that you're going to sample, man. You know, any tune that you used to bang in your mom's car when you was 8 years old or something like that, bro. And then in this case scenario, yeah, I went for this song by Black Eyed Peas, yeah, called Pump It, man. Let me play you this thing. Proper banger, bro. I remember banging this in my mom's car when I was 8 years old, bro. You know, pump it louder, man. Absolute tune, man. Bro, the adrenaline I would get, yeah, from banging this tune, bro. I swear to God, man. But yeah, man, that's step two. Step three, we're going to start putting things in the mixer track, bro. Yo, hey, wait, Testicle, what you want, brother? What you want?
Can I ask a question?
Yeah, go on.
How are you not putting things on the mixer track and you haven't even made the beat yet? Well, it doesn't make sense, brother.
Well, hey, wait, Testicle, listen up, brother. So, if you've listened to the melody, bro, you can see that I haven't done anything to it, bro. I haven't EQ'd it or nothing, bro. I've just put it in this one mixer track, bro. And the problem is with that is, you know, this melody has a lot of low frequencies in it, and when we start putting the drums on top, you know, it's gonna clash. So it's important that, you know, you EQ the melody before, you know, get started with the beat, man, so that don't happen. I mean, you could do it afterwards, but I prefer to do it, you know, at the start. And we also need to put two soft clippers on the master as usual. You know the drill, guys. So let's do that right now. So we got rid of the, you know, low frequencies that we didn't need, and we're also gonna put my, you know, my two soft clippers on the master preset on here. If you want to, you can go a step further and name this melody if you want. You know, maybe if you want to color it, you can color it. You know, I know you guys are into that, you know, preschool stuff. Coloring, hey, I like colors on my mixed track. you know, I prefer to keep it bland, but I'm gonna do it, you know, just for the sake of doing it. Okay, now that the boring stuff is out of the way, step four, it's time to start making the actual beat, man. Now, if you notice, the BPM of this is 150. That might be on the little bit of the faster end, you know. With sample drill, it can go from anywhere from 140, bro. I've even heard even slower drill beats than that, you know. and very fast draw beats that are going up to like 160 plus, bro. So, you know, the BPM really varies in this sort of like, you know, type of drill field, if you know what I'm trying to say. But yeah, man, I'm gonna start off with some fire counter sets, so let's get it, man. I like that. I'm gonna copy and paste this over to the ninth bar. That's good. I like that. I like that. Let's add a, you know, maybe a little perk. Let me put this in the mixer track and put some delay on this so it's like sort of fades away. That's sounding good so far. Let's add another sound on top of this thing, man. Yeah, that's a nice one. I'll put this at the start, like, of the pattern. Probably put some delay on it as well. That. Let's put a kick on this, bro. Yeah, thick as a beat. And that's more thicker than Megan Thee Stallion on a Thursday night after a girl's night out, bro. This is going well so far, man. Let's put this in the... Oh, never mind. I already did it. Never mind. Like an idiot. Okay. I'm going to put a snare now. I'm going to use the typical, you know, NY drill snare, man. That...
Yeah, boy.
That's sounding good nice. So far, man. Notice how I'm putting things in the mixer track, you know, on the way, and you know, mixing a few of them, you know, as I'm going, bro. I know some people prefer to, like, you know, put all the sounds and then mix them all at the end, bro. Sometimes I like, you know, doing it, you know, as I go, you know what I'm trying to say? You know, because it makes, you know, things much faster, I think, rather than just putting all the sounds in and, you know, spending all the time, hey, I'm gonna put a delay on reverb on this thing. I'm trying to say, just doing it on the way. Sounding good so far. Now I need to put a gunshot at the end, man. Don't worry, we're gonna get to the 808s, man. I know you lot are sitting there like, when you gonna put the 808s in? I wanna hear the 808. Like, ooh, bro, brother, calm down, bro. I'm not gonna miss out anything. I'm a professional, bro. Don't worry, man. I won't miss out the most important bit of the beat. Let's see. Yeah, definitely D. That's what I do, guys. That's actually, let me add that actually. You know, if you guys want to figure out, you know, the key of the sample, bro, there are many ways of doing it. You know, one way of doing it is you could put the 808 to a high note because it's easier to tell, you know, the sort of key when the 808's on the high note. Or, you know, there are various, you know, tools that you can use like auto key and stuff like that to find out the key of the sample. It's not always accurate 100% of the time. I'll give you, insight into it. Where's auto key? So if you let it play the sample, you say E major, some stuff like that, you know. It's not always accurate all the time, but it can be very accurate sometimes. So yeah, you can use tools like that, and you know, just use your ears, bro. You know what I'm trying to say? Like, it's not that hard. You know, I feel like it just takes, you know, a certain amount of time to, you know, just to be able to listen to a melody and already like detect the key, you know. I think that just comes over time. But yeah, you know, if you like pretty new to this stuff, you know, you can use those methods that I showed you. Man, speech impediment. There's others, but yeah, man, those are the two main ones I like to use. So let's go. Oh yeah, what we need to do as well, we need to put out all of this attack, you know, sustain, release, and put the hold all the way up. This is where we have control over the length of the 808. Essential tip, you need to know that. It's very quiet, man. I feel like I need to mix this a little bit. Okay, it's already in the mixer track, so. Let's put some sausage fattener on that, man. Yeah, sausage fattener makes the ting fat, bro. I might need some sausage fattener in real life, if you know what I mean.
My PP is so small. It's the smallest of them all.
Moments later.
Alright, that sounds good enough so far, man. We're gonna do some more mixing at the end on this 808. I don't want to add too many slides, you know, you want to keep it simple, you know, so the artist has some space as well. Oh yeah, there's another tip I need to show you guys. If the 808 seems to clash when the next one plays, click this thing called cut itself, so it stops when the next note comes in, instead of, you know, just running into each other. That's sounding so good, bro. This is basically finished, bro. This is basically finished, bro. We could probably add a few more 808 patterns, you know, along the beat, bro, and then that's pretty much done, man. You know, I might add in maybe an open hat or something in here. That's pretty much done, guys. So now we're getting onto the mixing, man. Now I think you guys already, you know, watched me mix a bit of this 808. You know, I'm gonna mix some of the other sounds such as the kick and stuff. I feel like in this case, bro, I might not use a preset, should I? Because then if I use a preset, you guys actually won't learn the process of how I mix the kick. You know what, bro, I'm gonna put a preset. I don't care, man. I'm trying to save time, man. You know, time is placements, you know, we don't have time to waste. So I'm gonna put this for now.
We'll be right back.
other sounds, bro, you don't really need to do too much, man. If there's too much muddiness in certain sounds, you know, you can maybe, you know, put a bit of EQ, you know, cut a little bit of the muddiness out. But usually I don't really EQ stuff like the snare and all that stuff. I usually just do the leveling. Guys, that's pretty much done. Now what we're gonna do, we're gonna arrange the beat, man, and then, you know, I'm gonna show you the full beat, man. So I'll be right back, guys. All right, guys, we are back and I have arranged the beat, guys. So I've added a few things why I, you know, was arranging the beat. You know, added some risers here, you know, just add that little bit of an effect, you know. I put a Fruity Love pilfter, you know what I'm trying to say, pilfter on the thing. The one that I used is, you know, just the standard, what was it? I swear it was triangle. Why did it disappear? I swear it was triangle low pan. Yeah, I used this one, by the way. And also, what I also did is that, you know, I did a bit more mixing on the 808. You know, I changed this thing here. And yeah, man, that's pretty much it, man. I'm gonna play the beat right now, and you guys can hear what the final product sounds like, man. So let me play it from here, man. I can't be bothered to just play it from the start.
It's amazing. It sounds way.
That's cold, bro. And it really just repeats itself from, you know, from there. You know, I couldn't be bothered to play it to the end. You know, man's got things to do, bro. And yeah, man, that's it for today's tutorial, man. I hope you guys enjoyed that, man. If you liked today's tutorial, man, you know the drill. Please subscribe, drop a like, you know, give me your credit card, your car keys, your 401k, fam, your mortgage, everything, bro. And, you know, cash at me, you know, some Bitcoin. Because man stays up late making these videos for you, man, bro. Lol, the irony, it's like 10:40 in the morning, so stay up late, bro. But anyways, yeah, man. And suggest some new, you know, content. I should make some new video topics. And I'll see you guys next time, man. I'm out, man. Peace.